Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So some more computer content. If you're new to this channel, I'm usually doing car content, but today I'm gonna do an upgrade on my laptop that I use for video processing. So if you saw a couple videos ago, I upgraded the memory on this new Dell G5 5500 laptop that I bought. And the main reason why I bought this laptop is it's got an Intel i5, which is not really that impressive as far as processing goes, but it's got a really good graphics card. I think it's a Ti 1660 from NVIDIA. That does most of the processing on my videos. And the memory, I put 32 gigs in there. Hardly ever uses 10 or 12 gigs out of the 32. Most of the processing is done by the GPU on this. So if you saw in that video, I tried to upgrade the SSD to a 2.5 inch that I had laying around, because I thought it would fit in this thing. And come to find out, in order to run a 2.5 inch, you actually can't run the M.2 drives on either of the ports that it has. You have to have an adapter and it takes up all that room. So the computer comes with the M.2, I think it's a 2230. Today I got this Abrint Rocket Q. It's an M.2, it's a 2280. So it's gonna fit in the second slot on here. It's a 1 terabyte. So today I'm gonna go through and just take it apart. I'm not gonna show you me taking it apart, because if you wanna check that out, you can see my last video. In order to upgrade on this one though, you need to order some parts from Dell. So you need to order the heatsink, the copper heatsink. So this thing is very important. It helps keep this thing cool, and then it also keeps it down because it's got the two screw holes in it. And then you have to order two screws. This computer is so new, you can't even find them anywhere except for Dell. Fortunately for us, it's petty cheap. I mean, this thing was only like $3 or $4, and I had to get two screws, which were $2 each, was kind of shaft. If you do a lot of computer stuff, you might have these two screws already laying around. I think they're M2. 3 millimeters. Yeah, this is the more important one to get from them, but I think I got both of all this less than $7.50 shipped to my door from Dell. So one of the first things you need to do when you take this thing apart, and I've already done it, was I released the battery cable, which is a little ribbon type thing that plugs into the motherboard. So as far as the part numbers go, when you call up Dell parts, you need the YX0F3. That is the part number right there that you're gonna need for this. When I called up and I gave them my actual model number on my computer, they said that it wasn't the one for this computer, but another YouTuber had left a comment on my other video. He got the same one and it fit on his computer, so I just ordered it anyway. It was only $3, right? And then the same with the screws. I just asked them for the M2x3 screws, and they just put two of those on the order. Today, I'm also gonna, when I'm done with putting this in, I'm also gonna repaste the CPU on here just to make sure the thermals on this thing stay okay. I decided to go with the Artic MX4. It's a little cheaper. It's probably like half the price of Kryonaut. One of the other members was using Kryonaut. Kryonaut is like $9 or $10 for 1 gram. I think this is like 4 grams for the same price. So I'm planning to repaste some other computers that I have, so I wanna be able to have some left over there. To get started, this is the M.2 2280 slot right here. So you just insert the new one in. This sink comes with a sticker that takes care of thermals onto the SSD, so you don't have to worry about pasting that, but you could probably paste it if you want to, but that thing won't stick if you do that. So I got this Rocket Q from Sabrent. It was on an Amazon deal for, I think, it's like $100 for a 1 terabyte. I'll post the link to this exact one in case it goes on sale or is any cheaper now, but I don't know what the going price for it was, but apparently it was a deal at $100, so I just picked it up. They make another version without the Q, which is like $30 more. I think it's a little bit faster, but since I'm using it strictly for storage, it wasn't really a big concern for me to go with a faster performance on this. So yeah, this guy, it comes with the sticker on the back. This thing comes with stickers on it too. I don't know if I wanna, this sticker is actually a heat sink also, so I'm just gonna leave that on there, and then I'll just probably double up with this sticker on this guy too. So yeah, you just pop it in, it's pretty simple, and it lines up since it's the standard mount, the M.2 2280 mount. right there. Two screws out. Anytime you install a new SSD on your machine, whether it's storage or not, I think you have to provision it. So once I get this done, I have to go inside and basically just set the disk or format it in administrative tools. So I'll show you guys how to do that once we get in there. Here it is, pretty easy, just two bolts. So it looks like to get to the CPU and the GPU, there's this huge heatsink with the dual fans on here. So there's actually 9 screws and they're all numbered 1 through 9. 9 is this tiny one right here. So we'll go ahead and remove all of these and then get access, kind of take that whole plate off, find out where we need to repaste the new thermal conductive paste, and then we'll put it all back together. So that was pretty easy to come off. Most of the screws, they're held on by retaining clips so they don't fall off the thing. So you can see the factory paste on the CPU and the GPU here. So I'm gonna go ahead and just wipe this down with just a regular paper towel, get the old paste off, and then I'm gonna put the new paste onto here. I've never done this before. This is all new to me, so I don't know what the exact process of cleaning this off. I'm just gonna just wipe it clean. Best I can. So I wiped it clean on both sides, on the process side, on the heatsink side. Now I'm just gonna lay down a bit of new paste on I'm gonna just put it on here and then use the little spatula it comes with to kind of spread it out. You could do it various ways. It's all going to eventually just spread out anyways, just because once you flatten it out. Good measure, I'm gonna put on both sides by overdoing it, but this computer runs pretty hot, so it's always good to have. Once you're happy with the amount of paste you have on, you just lay this thing back on and let it kind of spread out. So I got them all turned tight. Hopefully it spread pretty well. We'll monitor operation to see how the temperatures look. So we're gonna go in here. It didn't show up if you actually look at my PC. Nothing, it doesn't show up, just the whatever drive. So usually you have to go under here, you search admin tools, Windows administrative tools, go into here, and then I usually go under computer management. And under computer management, you'll go under disk management. And then
So you have to initialize the disk before you could access it. So it looks like it's disk one. So I just want to initialize it as a GPT, which is GUID partition table. So I'll hit okay on that one. Once I do that, you can see that it says unallocated on disk one. So I just right click it, and then I'll just call it a new simple volume. And then you go through the wizard. And basically, it asks you how much of that you want to partition. So I want to partition the whole thing. You could, if you want to partition into different drives or different disks, you can separate it into different drives, but I just keep it as one single partition, which is the whole thing. And then I'm going to assign it. I'm going to leave it as a, I think, D drive, but the C drive is the operating system drive. So I'm going to call it a D drive here. I'm going to leave it as a NTFS default allocation, and I'm going to call it just, I'm going to call it SSD storage drive. I'm just going to name the volume that, and then I'm going to just do a quick format and then finish. And then there it is. Now, if I go to my computer, it shows up as my SSD storage drive, drive D, which is perfect. Now I can move all my files there and free up my space in on my C drive for my operating system and my programs.
Hey guys, thanks for watching all the way to the end of this quick video on upgrading the storage drive to the M.2 2280 for the Dell G5 5500. It's a pretty easy, straightforward process. Just get it open, put it in there, and then partition and initiate the drive, the administrative tool disk management. So that's pretty easy. And then even the repasting the CPU and the GPU so it runs a little bit cooler, that's pretty simple too. So if you guys are interested in any of the products I use, check out the link in the description. I'll have the link to the MX4 paste, the drive, and then the screwdrivers and all that stuff I use. If you guys like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to your channel already, don't forget to subscribe to your channel. My channel is mostly car content, but once in a while I'll do these videos on computers and other technical stuff I do around the house. So anyways, thanks for watching guys, and I'll talk to you guys next time.